I have to figure out how the internet works. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is The Show at Night. We're back sooner than you probably expected. Here he is, your host, your star, Jazz Beckers! Josh is a cool guy, and he's got his own show. He's very funny, but you already know he'll entertain you. That's all I got now. Here's Josh. Ladies and gentlemen, we did it.
Look at this.
We made it. We're back. It didn't take half a year.
No.
It didn't take
like a week. It didn't even take a quarter of a year. No.
No. Hey, look, guys.
Not even a quarter of a month.
We missed you. We're back. It might not be the greatest thing we've ever put out every week, but we're giving it to you
right
now.
Hey, we're just here doing our thing, and you're there doing yours, so we're glad to be a part of it.
Very exciting night.
Very exciting night.
We have a returning guest doing something we haven't done in a
it's
while.
It's been too long since we've seen him.
It's true.
He adds value. He definitely adds value, unlike some of our other guests.
That's true. Some,
We will, shall remain nameless.
Of course.
But your other friends.
Yes. Guys, spring is here. Summer's coming. People are going to be outside. They're going to be dancing, you know.
Yeah,
parties
you know,
are happening.
I mean, a lot of things happen in the spring and summer that happen year-round.
Yeah.
But they happen more often, so they're more enjoyable. One of those things we're going to touch on tonight is
concerts.
Concerts. Live music, which we all enjoy.
We're in the season of festivals, outdoor shows.
Amphitheaters.
All those
scamphitheaters,
things.
All of them.
Carnivals, wherever you're playing, they're all starting up,
right.
They're all kicking off,
yeah.
And you know,
and there's a lot going on around us.
That's true. We're in a very centralized
yeah,
location.
We can get to a lot of places.
Realistically, a lot of festivals happening, not too far of a drive.
And let's be honest, our fan base reaches far beyond the St. Louis metropolitan area.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. Our fan base is, according to some metrics I looked at recently,
the analytics say
44% of our audience not even in the United States.
Is that right?
Would love to know. In the comments, please.
Let us
you
know
are
where
watching
you're
watching
us. Right. Give us a shout out from New Zealand.
Wherever you are, please let us know. But anyway, I think we get right to it.
Let's get right to it. Let's bring in our guests.
A lot of festival action out there, guys. There's a lot to see.
This guy's
a lot
an
of
expert.
Places to go.
This guy's an expert.
We brought
really.
In the foremost expert, our musical guru, you would say, maybe.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the show. After a long way, you've been asking for him. You've been wondering where he is. So have I. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Yacine, live in the satellite.
He's got a hairdo.
Hello. What's up?
Re-identified yourself as fast food.
Yeah, this is the Rally's Burger. I'm a big fan of Rally's.
Yacine, welcome back. It's been too long, I'd say.
Sure has.
Way too long.
You've gained a child, I believe, since the last time you were up.
A new child, and I've also gained some weight.
Ooh.
You look healthy.
And I'm just loving life.
Yeah.
You wear it well.
I mean, hey, we know you're loving life. We know you're a life lover.
Yeah.
And that is why we brought you on with your expertise. You've got your finger on the pulse of the music scene.
Oh, that's not what I thought you were going to say.
Well, he's got it up on other things.
Family show, Byron.
It's getting nice out. Things are happening everywhere. You are the man to talk to when it comes to live music. So we were thinking, let's bring a scene back and let's go over what some of the best festival opportunities are out there this year and where they're at, and tell us a little something.
Just give us a rundown, your opinion, some suggestions, recommendations for us and our fan base.
You got it. So I've looked at every festival going on this year.
Every
I found the top two, both equally awesome. First, Lollapalooza.
Lala.
Traditional, old standby.
Usually a very solid lineup. What's happening at Lala in Chicago?
Oh, do you know Kendrick Lamar?
I do know Kendrick Lamar.
Up and coming artist.
Yeah. Highly acclaimed.
He's going to be there.
You know, poet.
Kendrick Lamar live at Lollapalooza. That sounds good.
Yeah.
Start.
Billie Eilish.
Oh.
Ooh, I'm a fan of hers.
You know, I like her.
She's
too.
Intriguing.
She whispers a lot.
Yeah, but very loudly.
Mm-hmm.
Red Hot Chili Peppers is going to be there. You heard of them?
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah, sure.
I'll tell you one thing. Red Hot Chili Peppers are one of the few
bands that I really, really love and enjoy that I have yet to figure out a way to see at some point in my life.
Let's go.
Pardon my ignorance, but Lollapalooza always takes place in Chicago. Is that correct? Or does it
travel right. around? No.
It's a Chicago-based festival that is there every year.
There are zero festivals that travel around. I don't know what you're talking about.
That's not true.
I think a festival
The Outlaw Music Festival travels from town to town.
Well,
Smartbox.
No one's heard of that. Have you played that one? That sounds like a band festival that would have you on.
And what's wrong with that? Get back to your job and give it to
Lana Del Rey, I'm a fan of hers.
Oh.
Lana Del Rey. Diplo, Lil Yachty, Boogie with the Hoodie, who I'm a fan of. 30 Seconds to Mars, I've seen them. It's a good show. But there are people, a bunch of other people I don't know. So Lollapalooza, looking good this year. And then the second winner, Bonnaroo.
Oh,
Bonnaroofus. Is that in D.C.?
Yes, it is.
Huh.
Manchester.
That doesn't travel either, does it?
It's always there. It's been there forever.
Bonnaroo always seemed intriguing to me. Also seemed very intimidating.
It's a whole thing.
It is. Yeah, there's a lot going
on. Yeah, you're camping out. You're dirty. Everyone's dirty.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun. People are tripping on every kind of drug you can imagine.
Now, what's this? You've actually been to Bonnaroo.
I've been to Bonnaroo.
Expert at the group.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the scene? What's the vibe down there? Is there public places for bathing?
That's not my forte.
Can you bathe
with strangers?
Oh, you're bathing with strangers. Yeah. What I remember is they had like trailers, like shower trailers.
That's appealing.
That's fine.
That sounds great.
Do you get like your own private one?
It's pretty public, the one I remember, but I mean, you wear like a bathing suit or something, right?
So you don't go full naked. Shower trailers at Bonnaroo.
Yeah, and there's also some like kind of like public things where you can just like get a little fits, a little sitz bath, you know what I mean? Little sprinkler action.
Undercarriage rinse, like a little car wash thing. This kind of
you do the pits. Mm-hmm.
Oh,
get your hair washed off. Yes, I was in there quite a bit. Who are you trying to impress? Everyone stinks.
All right, so you said those were the two best. What were the two worst, and what's your reasoning and your criteria behind those?
Okay, big stinker this year. Coachella, the lineup stinks.
You know what? I saw the lineup for Coachella. Did not like it at all.
I know those people are.
They usually have at least, I don't know, 4, 5, 6 pretty massive acts.
Yeah.
Give them a little bit of the lineup, Yacine.
Here's the headliners.
Can I rename it? He said it stinks, so let's call it Coach Smella.
I like it.
I'm glad we interrupted the bit.
So we got Bad Bunny.
Who apparently the biggest star on the planet.
I guess so. He's huge. Yeah. I don't really know who he is.
I saw him on Saturday Night Live. I think he was a musical guest. Yeah. I watched like 3.5 seconds and I fast forwarded.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's typical SNL music act. We got Blackpink.
No clue. Never heard of
him. I don't know if that's a guy, if that's a girl. I don't even know.
Is that a band?
I'm going to guess girl.
You think I know? I don't know.
And Frank Ocean, who, like, I've heard some of his stuff, and he is good, but I don't care.
I prefer Billy Ocean.
I prefer Frank Stallone.
Is he not on the smaller
list? No.
It sounds terrible.
Sounds awful.
Okay. Well, Bjork's going to be there if that changes your mind.
Is that always in L.A.?
Oh, wait, one more thing about Coachella. Idris Elba is going to be a DJ there? I don't care if he spins records, though. His name's Del. Deltron? Delafunky Homo Sapien?
Yeah.
Him I like.
Okay.
If you want to listen to some good music, listen to Deltron 3030.
Here's my question. But will Shaq also be DJing at Coachella?
I hope not.
I don't know.
How much does a Coachella go for? And how long is the event? Just for future, just to give a point of perspective, like what are we talking about if you wanted to go to Coachella?
It's like a week long. It's April 14th to April 23rd.
Oh, they do 2 weekends. That's right.
Oh, it's 2 weekends? Okay.
Forgot they started doing
two. What are you doing in the middle of the week? Go to school?
You're telling me there's 2 weekends of this, and those are all the headliners you just mentioned.
They're each performing two different nights. Correct. I'm done with Coachella.
Yeah, I'm going to call it No-Cella. So, you said what is the absolute worst music festival of 2023 coming from your lips to our viewers' ears?
Well, Josh, I hate to do this to you because I know this is your favorite. Ooh. Beale Street Music Fest.
All right.
Now, you've been there a bunch.
How out of... Okay, please tell us.
No. I will absolutely agree because this is my favorite music festival. We used to go every year. Me and a buddy of mine, 5 years in a row, we went. It was the greatest time. COVID hit, and they've had 2 shows since then. Last year was fine. This is so bad that I'm shocked it's even that.
Garbage.
Beale Street needs to bounce back.
Give us a little bit. Give us the headlines. Give us the big
ones. Yeah, you got it. So, Lumineers.
Fine. They're not terrible.
No, but...
I mean, what is this, 2017? Greta Van Fleet?
Greta Van Fleet is a rock and roll band.
Here's how I meter how good these bands are for the festival. I look at it as it's about a four and a half hour drive. Am I driving 4.5 hours to see any of these bands?
No.
Here's my measure. Name a song.
It's true.
Can you name a Greta Van Fleet song?
No.
Not by title.
I can name a few Lumineers songs.
Go ahead. I'm not trying to be a contrarian. That doesn't sound like the worst festival out there.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair.
But you're talking driving out of town. You're talking gas, as expensive as gas is these days. You're talking hotel rooms.
Easy.
You're talking food.
Yeah.
All that stuff.
Yes, all that stuff.
There are also Earth, Wind, and Fire, Ziggy Marley, Glorilla.
Who?
Gary Clark Jr. That would be good, actually. And look, with festivals, they're not all stinkers, right? I mean, you can find a good few good diamonds in the rough, but like you just got to judge the whole thing and the headliners.
Okay. Well,
that was very informative. Hey guys, I learned a lot.
Make your travel plans accordingly. You know, there's a lot of action out there, a lot of festivals. But now that you've got Yacine's supreme opinion on this, I would follow it. I agree with everything you said about these festivals.
I was happy that the two recommendations are festivals that I am aware of.
Yeah.
Like I know the name, you know, Bonnaroo, Lollapalooza.
Yeah.
Got those down. There's no one called Camp that I know you've attended, right? There's plenty.
Yeah, there's plenty.
Yeah. Anyway.
We are going to take a short break here. And when we come back, Yacine, if you'd like to join us, we are going to bring back an old bit. And we're going to go over the Billboard Hot 100 Top 5. Let everybody know what the hot sounds of spring are looking like right now.
I can't wait.
All right. Well, hey, guys. We're going to take a quick break.
We'll be right back after this.
Go back into your burger.
Skitty, bop, boop,
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and we are here with our buddy Yacine to bring back a segment that we did before. We didn't invent it or anything, but no. We did it for you.
Yeah.
And it was fun. A little discussion. Going into spring, it's that time of year where, you know, you're going to maybe start hanging out on the deck, hanging out on the lawn.
Patios.
Patio, wherever you're at. Go lay out in the grass. Go
pool
to the park.
Sides right around the corner.
Obviously.
My favorite spot.
I'm seeing blooms everywhere, flowers, buds, trees, everything. It's nice.
So while you're out there and you're hanging out and if you're going to be around people, let's give you guys an idea of what the hot new tunes are.
Hot new tunes.
As we break down for you and dissect and discuss and absorb.
Well, we're going to offer our reactions and our opinions.
The top 5 songs on your latest edition of the Billboard Hot 100. Coming in at number 5.
Cinco.
Is a collection of people, and as the hip-hop expert, Yacine, maybe you can explain a little bit more of this to me, because I'm only familiar with some of these. Your number 5 song for the week is Creepin' by Metro Boomin, The Weeknd, and 21 Savage. And can we cue that up? Fellas, thoughts, reactions, opinions. The number five. There's only four songs in the world that are hotter than this.
In the US.
I'm a huge fan of 21 Savage. Huge fan of The Weeknd. I think The Weeknd is the most streamed person on the planet right now, according to Spotify. Metro Boomin, is he a producer? He doesn't actually rap, does he? I think he's a behind-the-scenes guy.
My biggest question about this song is I don't know who Metro Boomin is.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's interesting, though. It's a thing that's like goes on these days where he's got top billing when the names get listed on this song.
That's surprising because so he's the only one I don't recognize the name of.
So I guess you just are a producer and you make a beat and then you go, I'm going to pay you and you to be on my song. But it's
a yeah. He probably also just writes the song and does everything except for the singing, is my guess.
I think I said all I needed to say while it was playing.
I'm hungry now. I'm thinking about Rubens.
Okay, number four song in the country. Believe it or not, there's only three songs in the country that are better than this one.
All right, let's hear it.
We'll find out just how they were able to pull that off here shortly. But number four is Kill Bill by SZA. S-Z-A. Is that SZA?
Yeah, so, yeah. I think so.
None of us are sure.
I don't, yeah.
I would.
S-Z-A. I would see that and think Z.
Z.
But like the RZA from Wu-Tang and the JZA from Wu-Tang.
I don't know. RZA. Why does it have to be so fucking complicated?
Now, ladies and gentlemen, at number four, it's Kill Bill by SZA.
SZA.
So that's the fourth best song.
It's way better than the fifth.
In the United States.
Way better than the fifth best song.
When did Kill Bill come out? Like 20 years ago?
It's got a very comfortable, familiar melody line.
It does.
You know? It's got a decent chord progression that is a nice bed for the melody line.
Yacine, what do you think about that song?
So SZA's a chick?
Apparently.
Yes, I believe. As far as I'm aware, yes.
I thought it was the Wu-Tang person. Was that RZA?
That's RZA or JZA.
So this is SZA? I think I know her. I think I work with her.
This is SZA.
Well, okay. I like the song. It's nice.
It's pulling a little something from like the Dionne Warwick sound of the 70s. Okay. You know, those kind of like, it's not.
Yeah, totally.
As many of you are completely aware of.
Move along.
Number three song in the country. Is country music superstar.
Ooh.
This guy is taking over the world of country music, apparently. He's playing in St. Louis this year. Two sold-out shows, back-to-back nights at Busch Stadium.
Who's this?
This is Morgan.
Morgan Wallen.
Morgan Wallen.
And
I like him.
He's very popular.
He is very popular. And he's talented, I think.
He's...
upset songwriter.
He's a musician. Here's his big tune that's out right now. Number three in the country.
Mm-hmm.
Last Night by Morgan Wallen.
Not Whalen, it's Wallen.
I'm not sure, but he's got the number three song in the country, and this is what it sounds like.
Kiss and live, make your grip to see, flip the frame to see if. Last bottle of death, we split a fifth. Just talking about life, don't sip, sip. And you know you love the fight.
Okay, so I do like that song.
Okay.
It's not my favorite song by him,
mm-hmm.
but, you know, there's some hooks in the lyrics that I think are clever. I'm just saying, it's in the theme of traditional country music. It's, you know, I mean, Dylan wrote a bunch of songs like that, and he wasn't country, but Americana songs about, you know, unrequited love, mm-hmm. you know, breakups and get back togethers and all that. I mean, that is a universal human theme.
It sounds like you're saying it's not creative. And that's kind of what my thought is. I mean, I've heard a thousand country songs like this. I'm a fan of country. I think it's one of those mediums where you can tell a really good story. This one, though, it's just boring to me. Especially when talking about like a fifth of Jack, like that's so corny and cliche.
Well, I mean, hey, it's not the craziest thing he's been recorded saying, but like
it's fine. You two only played one show,
exactly,
and there's two in their name.
Mm-hmm. Well, speaking of two, here about it? Number two.
Let's see what I did there for you,
and we'll also get to the second best song. this was the number one song last week, but it has been bumped. Is officially in the number two slot right now.
Wow.
And I'll be honest, it's a song I like. It's a good tune by an artist who I've grown to really appreciate and love and think is very talented.
Okay.
The number two song in the country is Flowers by
I knew it. Miley Cyrus.
Cyrus. Flowers. She's my jam.
Well, I'm sure she would love to hear that.
Yeah.
I think for a while she was kind of just trying to do whatever to like get out of her teen image. And then I think she really settled into who she is
she can
as
sing.
An artist.
I mean,
oh,
she can sing.
She's got an amazing voice.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I would.
I feel guilty like Miley Cyrus, but I kind of do. I think I just do. And I'm just going to say it to the world.
We're all
I'm a fan.
This is your platform. Tell us what you think and how you feel.
I'm just a fan. I like this song. I like the last song that she did. I can't think of the name of it. It's just good. I don't know. And it's been it's been number one for like months, I think. So I think this song will last the test of time also. I think in 10 years, this will be on the radio somewhere. It'll still get streams. I think it's a good song.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I can definitely see this in the same vein as like Mr. Brightside by The Killers. It just like never went away. Just
yeah.
We'll hear it on the radio probably somewhere at least once a day.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go, guys. The number one song in the country. I'm not going to lie. I don't know who this person is. And
is it Blackpink?
I never heard this song before the list came out. I was not even aware this song existed, but here we are. The number one song in the country is called "Like Crazy" by Jimin.
Oh, stop it! I hate it already.
Oh, this is K-pop. K-pop.
That's the number one song. Give me a break.
I will say,
hold on. Can we let Yacine speak?
Yeah. I need to gather my mind.
Yacine.
It's my first time hearing that song and hearing of this person. I guess it's K-pop or something. I know it's a huge worldwide phenomenon. I can't get into it. I don't know. I'm not.
Thank you.
I'm not. I don't have any connection to it.
Here's the thing. I love big, overproduced pop music. I love.
Did not these know bands. This about you.
Yeah. If the more that's going on, I mean, to an extent, but yeah, I do love that stuff. I don't know who this guy is.
They're in BTS. I've heard of BTS. It's like the number one.
I know who BTS
is. I've heard of that. That is K-pop.
He's from BTS.
Okay, he's from BTS.
The Harry Styles of BTS. He's breaking off.
He's the first ever solo South Korean to top US charts. That's something.
And it is
something.
I don't understand a single word in this song. It sounds incredibly overproduced.
Very much so.
And there's such an effect on the voice.
Well,
I just.
So it's, yes.
And I'm just
the
wondering
overproduced.
Who are the people that are the radio people that are just, and the people, well, I mean, I guess they count streams now, right? So.
Okay, here's the deal. I understand that most of the music industry these days is this canned product that producers and studios and record labels, if there is such a thing anymore, put together and throw out there, right? Mm-hmm. You know, and they add their sound and all this stuff. That is so produced that I feel zero emotional connection to the music.
Yeah.
And I feel that the singer of the song has zero connection to their music.
Oh no, this is
And music, it comes from personal experience, a place of passion, a place of emotion. and that lacks all of that.
I think you're right, Byron. It's just, it's so produced. It feels like it's made in a lab with like focus groups and stuff. I've given it a legit shot to try to listen and enjoy to K-pop, and I just can't. I don't know. Maybe I'm just not too old or something.
Give Miley her spot back.
Give Miley her spot back.
That's the best song on the list.
Morgan up a notch from 3 to 2.
Bro?
Okay, that's fair.
And that would drop out of the top 5 for me.
Amen. Is that the number one song in the country? I'm very happy for him.
Well,
wish him
good job, Damon.
I don't
take the vocal effects off because I can't understand what he's saying. It's
you're not saying anything. He's not saying anything. That's the whole. Even if you can hear him, he's not saying anything of value.
Well, you know.
I'm sorry.
We'll check in with Jimin next week.
Probably. No, we won't.
We'll see what he has to say about all this. But there it is.
All right, thanks.
Your top 5 songs. Take that information for what you will. Use it. Throw it onto your playlist. Well,
people value our opinion on things, and we just offered it. That's it. That's just our take.
So now you know to either listen to or not listen to some of those songs.
And which festivals to go to and which not to go to, thanks to our friend Yacine.
Yeah. Before you make all your travel plans, you got a playlist for the car. You got a destination to go to or not go to.
And if you're local here in St. Louis, you can check out the Driftwoods at Columbo's.
Yeah, sometime
again. May 13th show.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
May 13th.
Look at that. Hey, book your tickets now.
They're free. Just come out and hang out. It's fun.
There you go.
Yacine won't be there because he just doesn't like me that much. But
I'll be there. I'll go.
Show. And just remember, you get what you pay for.
Oh, do they have Rubens?
I don't know if they have a Reuben on the menu or not.
And I'm out.
That was good.
Speaking of being out, that's all for us tonight, guys. Thank you all for coming back
soon.
Well, thanks for having me. I enjoyed my time tonight.
See you again. Thanks for joining us. We always appreciate your insight.
Yacine, it was great to have you back. Thank you for all the information. Some things were more confused than we were before, but.
And we got back on this Zoom thing.
Yeah.
Which, you know.
Hopefully next time we can make this so you can finally make your appearance in the show at night studio.
Mm-hmm. I can't wait.
Yeah, it'd be great. Yeah. All right, thanks for joining us. Thank you for watching us. We appreciate all your support.
Everybody at home, enjoy the lovely outdoors. Enjoy the tunes. More tunes are coming, I hope. Because we can't stop with Jimin.
No, we're gonna have to do something else again. Maybe a trivia thing. Pit these two guys against each other. It's fun.
We'll see what happens.
Take care. As we always say.
For me here at the show at night, for Byron, for Yacine, for everybody, for all of you, as we always say,
bye!
Bye.
Yeah. Quit pawing me.
What a fun show. And I'm out.